We are going to find the equation to the tangent plane. My problem says find an equation of the plane tangent to the given surface D equals F of xy at the indicated point P. So the problem they give me is Z, and we'll do that little line to make sure that that's not a 2, equals x squared plus y squared, and the point that they give is 3, 4, 25. So they're asking for the equation of the plane intersecting the graph of this function at this point, just like in calculus when we were only using the single variable, they are asking for the line intersecting the graph at a certain point. It's just the plane intersecting the graph at a certain point. So, because it's like 3D instead of 2D. So, this isn't actually really all that difficult. All we have to do is take the derivative of this equation with respect to both x and y, and then kind of plug in. So what we're going to do is go ahead and say partial derivative of the function z with respect to x, and then partial derivative of the function z with respect to y. We have to find these two things. So partial derivatives, first we're taking with respect to x, and the derivative of this equation here, with respect to x is 2x. The y squared goes away. With respect to y, it's 2y because the x squared goes away. And now that we have the partial derivatives, what we do is plug in this point to these to get the slope in the x direction and the slope in the y direction. So this here, keep in mind, is x, y, z point always. So we're going to plug in 3 for x. So this is going to be 2 times 3. So this will be 6. And then here, we're going to plug in y. Y is 4. So 2 times 4 is 8. So now we now have the slope in the x direction and the slope in the y direction. And so all we have to do is plug in. The formula that we're looking at, in mine it's called the plane tangent to a surface, and what that basically is going to look like is z, I'm not going to write this whole thing out this time. What we're going to do is z minus the z coordinate here, 25, equals, and then we always plug things in the same spot. So the 25, the z coordinate always goes here. Then we have slope in the x direction, which is 6, times x minus the x point, which is 3, plus the slope in the y direction, 8, times y minus y point, which is 4. We always plug things in this order. We always have z here, always have the point at z here, slope in the x direction, x minus x point, slope in the y direction, y minus y point, always, is how we start this equation. So now that we've plugged everything in, and you notice before we had started, they gave us, you can see, they gave us z, x, and y. We solved for 6 and 8, slope in the x direction, slope in the y direction. So those are the elements we solve for, and we write in z, x, and y here. So that's how we kind of break down those elements. So now all we have to do is simplify and solve. Really just simplify. So we're just going to multiply out. You could either give your answer in this form, or you could change it to the following form. I'll show you both. We'll say z minus 25 equals, and then we're just gonna multiply out here. So 6x minus 18 plus 8y minus 32 z equals, we're gonna add the 25 to the other side. But you should always do 6x plus 8y first, the x plus the y, and then the constant. So negative 18 minus 32 is negative 40, negative 50 plus 25 is still negative 25. Okay, so we combine the 25, the 18, and the 32 to get the 25. And that's it. So either your answer can look like this, and that's usually perfectly acceptable, or it can look like this, which is also great. Same thing, we just simplified it here. I kind of prefer this way, unless they ask you for this specific equation. That's it.